In this lesson, we are adding cliff detection feature using grayscale module. When our robot is pushed to the cliff, it backs off. Very cool. Hi, welcome to a product tutorial by Robojax. This is SunFounder's PICAR-X Raspberry Pi self-driving robot car kit.
Hello friend, how are you? Turn left here. Count down to 3 seconds. 3, 2, 1. Rock. I lost.
This grayscale sensor, which I've explained it in the previous lessons, we can read the amount of reflection from the surface. So we have 3 sensors and each has a transmitter and receiver. One is infrared transmitter, which sends the beam. The other is getting back the reflection and we are reading it. The amount of reflection depends on the surface. If the surface is black, it will have very little reflection, but on the white surface or any other surface or gray or different color, we will have very high reflection. And when we have no reflection, it means it's black. So that's why here, when we bring this on this area, this is a table. From this area, it goes way low. And when the robot approaches and reaches this area, the infrared will go back and there will be no reflection. And as a result, it will detect the cliff and the robot, we can stop it or do something. In this case, we are going back. The surface that we have will have different reflection, the amount of blackness or how black it is or how white or gray it is. So this will have different result. And for that, for each surface that you're testing, if the light condition changes, then you have to do a calibration or tell the robot what are the values so it can detect the cliff. To understand it better, I'm creating a cliff here on this table. This is black and we are on the white area. And as soon as it moves to the black area, you see it detects the cliff because from the black area, there is no reflection. And also to show you better, I will turn off the light. Look at this. Now you see the this light, when it detects, it will change. You see when I bring it on the white paper, it turns on and it detects, and here it does not. So there is some space. Let me bring it like this so you can see the light. So the you see that these lights are on and we are at this distance, and if we go on the cliff, there is no light. Can you see it? We see the 3 lights are on, and when it goes over the cliff, so the lights are off. Now let's read the values on the screen. When you come to docs.sunfounder.com, you will see this page. Scroll down under the robot kit. You will find PICAR-X car kit version 2 with battery. Click on that. On the left side, you will see different options. Select play with Python and click our number 6, cliff detection. Here we have some explanation. The code that we are running is called sex.clefdetection.py, which is located inside PICAR-X, and then example. We can run this code the same as before. If you install the SunFounder create agent, but we are going to run it from the command line. Here is the explanation for this, and I'm going to explain the code fully. First, let's find out the IP address of our robot. Go to PowerShell, right click and run as administrator. And let's type ping -4 robojax.local, that is the host name that I set. IP address is 192.168.0.102. Open VNC player, we have shown you how to install it. And 192.168.0.102. Enter the IP address. You will get the warning, accepted. Enter your username and the password. I've selected username and password and then click OK. Here is our screen. Go to the terminal. Click on this file manager, go to PICAR-X, and then double click on examples. Double click on examples. Let's see the files in list like that. So number 6, clef detection, just double click. I'm using the wheel on the mouse to increase. We are importing PICAR. We are importing from PICAR-X, the PICAR-X class. And then from time also we are importing sleep. And from robot hat, we are importing TTS. This is text to speech. And from text to speech, we are creating an object called TTS with lowercase. And here for the TTS, we are setting TTS.language. From here, you can set your language. From this class of PICAR-X, we are creating PX object. And these are the reference when PX set clef reference 200, 200, 200. And then current state is set to none. And then this is a PX power. And then the offset is 20, we are going to see it. And then the last state is safe. So when it moves on the clef, it changes it. Initially it's safe, so it can proceed. And the program runs from here, try. And then it says while true, so this will run forever. So this try will run as long as there is no exception. F or exit, when it's finally there is exception or exit, it runs this px.stop and prints this on the screen with 0.1 second and program is done. We are getting the list of grayscale value, px get grayscale data, so this will get the data and it will have it as a list. This list that we pass, it gets the state based on the value that we set. So this state, we can print it if you want by uncommenting this line. So it will print it for us. This value that we have, we will see it practically. This will print the state depending on the clef or if it is not on the clef. And also we have these values. So we are going to, I'm just setting it to save, and then let's run the code. CD PICAR, I'm pressing tab to complete it, EX and then tab, and then we are going to run this number 6, sudo python 3 and 6 dot, press tab to complete it. Hello? I'm pressing enter. So that as soon as I run it, the car is running. Now it says status clef is true. So this is now giving us the clef true because there is no reflection. Now let me bring some simple reflection. As soon as it gets the reflection, it says it's false because it's on the ground, right? And here it's danger and false. Now the amount that how sensitive this is, now pay attention, now it's like this. Now there is reflection, and as soon as we go on the cliff it starts running. Okay. So the value is either true or false. So I run Control C, but still, because at the moment that it was turned off, it caused this to run like this. And here we check if this status grayscale module, this GM state or grayscale module state is equal false, which means it is on the ground and there is no cliff. Then we set the state to false because this is needed later, and then we stop the car because the car needs to just stop and there is no danger. But if it is not false, which means it is true, that it goes to else and it sets the state to danger and sets the car to go backward with 80% speed. And here we have another condition inside this else. If it is true, then also we check if the last state was safe. Then we pronounce this word danger using text-to-speech, so we can hear it from speaker and give it 1/10 of the second. And after this else and if finished, then we set the state, the last state, with the value of the state that we have, either safe or danger. So this will just set it, and the loop will continuously run, and our car will always be stopped if it's not on the cliff. Only when it's on the cliff, it goes backward until, and it continues until it reaches back to the safe area, which means in few centimeters. And if something goes wrong with a programm or there is an exception, the finally will run and the code will stop and this text will be printed. And sometimes when you stop your programme, any of these programs for PICAR-X, the robot might not stop fully. Some of the motors, maybe left or right, will continue running because you are interrupting it somewhere at the middle and some instruction stays. To stop that, let's create our own stop program so we can run it if the robot is not stopping. Let's create a stop program because it seems the robot is just running. I'm going to copy this move and here copy. Paste, and then let's name it stop. Stop.py. So move is there and we created stop. Let's double click and open it. Because this is running everything, we just need a stop. So we just need a stop and it will run. save. And now we can run the code. The robot is still running. Let's run our code. Sudo python 3 stop.py. And I'm running the code now, so the robot is stopped. Let's run the cliff detection program when the robot starts. Let's open the terminal. And so first we have to know the exact location of our file, cd PICAR-X, and then example dir. So this is the cliff detection, but we have to use print working directory, pwd. We can use this one or we can use alias as well. So this is the location, and at the end we will put this name. Let's copy the file name so we do not make mistake. PICAR-X examples. So this is the number 6 cliff detection. Rename, and then we don't rename it, copy and go back to the terminal, and let's clear this. Type sudo crontab minus e. This will allow you to edit it. I'm using arrow to go down, and here I remove it, and then we type at reboot python 3 and then the full path, and then with the arrow come here and let's put our file. So that's our file, the full path to the file, and then we press Control O for write out and enter, and then Control X to exit. You will see this installing a new cron tab. Now we can reboot. Now the lights are on, it's booting. So it's blinking. So it is detecting now the cliff. And if I bring something to it, so it detects the surface and it stops. Now I'm gonna put it here back. As you can see, it stopped. It doesn't do anything, and because it has detected and the lights are on. Now let's push it a little. So as soon as I push it, it backs off. So it detects the cliff and it works perfectly. Thank you for watching. I will see you in the next lesson.